This is the Truth Frequency Radio Network.
We are TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Can you count, suckers? I say the future!
Broadcasting straight to you from a large spaceship, currently anchored, yes, anchored until further notice, above Raleigh, North Carolina, eagerly awaiting the 2017 Flat Earth International Conference, although tonight we are going to be talking about the NBA, so don't confuse this with a different episode. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, the creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Check it out at marksargent.com, enclosedworld.com, or just Google Flat Earth Clues. If you can't find it, it's because you've been severely distracted by all the major basketball news that happened over the weekend, which we'll talk about in just a bit. For those of you listening to this on YouTube and you want to hear the show live as it happens, please go to Truth Frequency Radio for the latest schedule. Currently, this show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern, and tonight is Tuesday night. So if you are listening to this and it is not Tuesday night, that means it is not live, so please do not call into the show. Normally, I would give out the show number, but we're still waiting for the phone system to be rebooted, so I can't add you in right this second. So do not call right now. We'll probably have to wait maybe the first break. Who knows? We'll see. Quote of the day from the Peanut Gallery is, "The important thing is not to stop questioning. Curiosity has its own reason for existence. One cannot help but be in awe when he contemplates the mysteries of eternity, of life, of the marvelous structure of reality. It is enough if one tries merely to comprehend a little of this mystery each day." I really love that quote. I wish I would have thought of it. It is from An Old Man's Advice to Youth, Never Lose a Holy Curiosity, from Life magazine, May of 1955, page 64. And the guy who said that was Albert Einstein. And I don't care if people say that he plagiarized a lot of stuff and he wasn't the smartest man ever and Nikola Tesla was, you know, leagues above him. I don't really care. I will say this. Albert Einstein is probably one of the most quotable guys. His quotes are so fantastic. Very, very creative and very unusual for a scientist because they have all these cool meetings. What else are we going to talk about before we get to the basketball? So Jeffrey Grupp Challenge is still in effect. If anyone wants to debate against Flat Earth, please let me know. You can email me at msargent23@comcast.net or leave a message at 720-897-6111. And I will see if I can set you up. But you got to be somebody. You got to be a professional debunker or someone in academia, somebody. So please, you know, let me know, because he's gathering dust over there. No one's willing to go up against him. We just have a hard time having people come up against us, to be honest. The Flat Earth Conference, which I'm going to bring up literally on every show before then, and as you know, the spaceship is anchored, is going to be in November 9th and 10th in Raleigh, North Carolina. Excuse me. And it's going to be a great time, so check that out. You guys can find out all the information on that, but you can always call in with questions, and I'll answer what I can. I'm going to try to update with a video every single week on my channel, at least one video a week. But it'll be in Raleigh, North Carolina, the 9th and 10th of November of this year. The website is fe27.com. And before we get into emails, anything else, a couple other things I want to mention. One is somebody called me, and I don't usually answer the phone, but sometimes I do. I've been answering the phone more, especially since this basketball thing's been happening. And mentioned, hey, has anyone ever mentioned, and I'm sure somebody in the Christian community has, but if they haven't, somebody please forward this quote to anyone in the Christian community. Has anyone looked at threshing circles? Threshing, threshing circles. He goes, they look really interesting. The symbolism behind them, you know, that you're using them to sort out the good parts from the bad parts of whatever you put in there. Oh, that's really interesting, because I was looking at the pictures of threshing circles, and I found them fascinating. So the guy, I forgot his name, who called in with it, thank you very much for that. And I will start including some threshing circle slides in the video background when I'm doing this. Okay, before we get to emails, because again, can't do the phones right now, so nobody call in. I will just hang up, or I'll send you a voicemail right away, because I got to wait for the phone thing to be rebooted. And that is, if you got, unless some you were hiding underneath a rock this weekend, what a difference a week makes. Here we were, we're announcing the conference last show and talking about the conference. So the conference was announced barely a week ago, right? And then 5-6 days later, the most interesting thing happens. And you can follow this on Google, or you can just go to my YouTube page and you'll see all the videos I started posting starting on February 17th. So in the United States, we have the National Basketball Association. I don't know if it's the second or third biggest sport, but we've got American football, we've got American baseball, and we've got basketball. And we've got in basketball, you've got the All-Star break, where the best of the best fly out to a host city and they do all their fancy stuff. And it's really, really cool. Well, Kyrie Irving, K-Y-R-I-E-I-R-V-I-N-G, who plays for the Cleveland Cavaliers, world champions right now, he teammate of LeBron James, he was flying to the All-Star break, which was out in New Orleans. And he was being interviewed. You know, they have a lot of downtime, the players do. So when they are on planes, they're watching a lot of YouTube and they're watching a lot of shows. Because especially with basketball and baseball, because there's a lot of games. You're on planes a lot. And baseball, I don't even know how they do it. They're just so much freaking downtime. But basketball, not as much. So he's being interviewed, and one of his teammates decides to kind of chime in. And going, because he knew that Kyrie was into conspiracies. And Kyrie goes down the road of flat earth. And his friends kind of, he's pulling him along. And Kyrie spends a good 15 minutes talking about, not necessarily all the details about flat earth, just that it's very, very possible and very, very real. And he believes the earth is flat. And it wasn't a half-assed comment or anything like that. He was really getting into it. Under no uncertain terms. Well, here's the problem with that. Right? It's not the problem, but here's why it blew up so huge, is that when he got, by the time he had landed, this thing, they already posted this thing on the internet. And it does, you got to remember that in the sports world, the athletes, especially on a professional level, I don't care what sport it is, they are trained to, number one, football says, yeah, I knew that because of the sheer amount of players that it takes. And hang on, the peanut gallery is telling me. And number two is baseball. Number three is college football. Oh, that makes sense. Yeah. And number four is men's basketball. Okay. In U.S. Got it. Anyway, it's still really huge. Anyway, so no matter what kind of athlete you are, stop shooting me things. I gotta finish this story. No matter what kind of athlete you are, you're trained to say a lot of robotic things. Give 110%. We play well as a team and a team effort, and the other guys did okay, but we had more. We wanted it more. Blah blah blah. Win lose, all that sort of athletic rhetoric. And athletes rarely say anything thought provoking. Say the least, very very rarely do they say stuff that's controversial. So when one of the number one basketball athletes in the world comes out and he says that the earth is flat, people pay attention. And you couldn't have asked for a better venue, because he's landing in a city where the media, everyone in the sports world is there. It's a fun time to be at, a fun place to be at for the media. So in fact, they have media day where all these reporters are just coming in. And who do they want to talk to? They want to talk to Kyrie because it's an interesting story, especially when they listened to his podcast and found out he wasn't joking. And so they were really pressing him on it, really, really pressing him on it. And he was not backing down. Now, I know some people say, no, he kind of retracted. And he made that one statement where he said, well, he goes, that science shows us that the earth is round. But you got to listen to the words. He was saying, no, the science shows us. It's not that it proves. They were showing us. That's what science puts forward. And it was very, very interesting. Hang on, I got to read the peanut gallery here because he's not. You were quoting Bedazzled 2000 for NASCAR. Sorry. Okay. Anyway, so it was fascinating. So I immediately jumped on this and I made a video called NBA Star Kyrie Irving Radio Interview. So I posted that radio interview when he was on the plane before he landed in New Orleans for the All-Star game. Then, of course, the media world exploded because he didn't backtrack from it. And two things happened right away. So the very next day, so February 18th, that was, I think, on that Saturday, another guy from the Golden State Warriors, Draymond Green, Draymond, and I've got a video for that. He is, you know, because why not? If you're in the Midwest media circus, you have access to all these basketball players. You ask Draymond, hey, Draymond, what do you think of Kyrie Irving's statement? And Draymond's goes, you know what? It's very possible. It could be flat. And he didn't have as much conviction, but the fact that he was not laughing at Kyrie. And then they were asking LeBron James, who was sitting within, I don't know, 15 feet of Kyrie. And LeBron was saying, you know what? Whatever he believes in, he goes, it's totally okay with me. And that's when the media world was like, okay, what is going on? So then it just got just super weird. Everybody covered this. So all you have to do is go into any search engine, type in Flat Earth, and click on the news button. Now, you don't even have to click on the news button, but the news will give you all the articles. Basically, every sports periodical and every mainstream news outlet covered it, at least on the internet. And in fact, I did a follow-up video, because I did like 6 or 7 videos, more than that probably. So then on the 19th, I actually narrated a CNN article called Kyrie Irving, LeBron James, and Why a Flat Earth is Okay. And put that out there with some slides, and because it was a fairly decent article, which tied, because again, no one of course is going to believe it right away. I would be shocked if they did, but the fact that CNN was covering it, at least in internet form, was intriguing to me. And then and I knew what was going to happen on Monday. I didn't really talk about this with anybody else, but I knew that by the time, because this happened over a weekend, and then Monday you've got your weekly shows that have to deal with it. So everybody on Monday, all the sports shows on Monday had to deal with it. So Sports Illustrated, one of their shows, they dragged in Bill Nye, and so I did a video where I took his clip where Bill Nye addressed Kyrie Irving, and of course Bill Nye, the science idiot, because he's not a scientist, but you can hear that rant. Just a short version of this. Bill Nye is literally just a science guy. He's a guy who talks about science. He has a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering. That's it. He has a master's degree in nothing and no ology. I don't care what it is, biology, archaeology, geology, astrophysics, astronomy. It doesn't really matter. He has none of these qualifications. But because he looks like the ultimate stereotypical nerd, they bring him in under the camera. He's really good as coming across as this science credible guy on camera, even though he has no business being there at all. They'll ask him questions about anything, meteorology, astrophysics. He's on panels that he knows nothing about this stuff. Anyway, so I did a video on that, and then the Monday morning the shows started coming in, which was yesterday. So ESPN has a series of shows, different, ESPN has a bunch of different channels. So Sports Nation came out, and I did a video, is Kyrie Irving right about Flat Earth? And they were duking it out really on stage. And then The Jump, another show on ESPN, they're reacting where it, you were actually listening. The guy that was talking about conspiracy was amazing because he was actually bringing up conspiracies you're never supposed to bring up on network television. He's talking about JFK and the Boston or and the Twin Towers. He even brought up the Trump birther thing. Thought for sure they were just going to go to black. Sorry, 334, cannot pick you up yet because we haven't rebooted the phone system. And then I did my 100th interview with the Daily Helmsman, and I only mentioned that. I don't usually mention my interviews on this show, but I have to mention it because they called me after hearing about Kyrie Irving. It was a mostly, if I'm not mistaken, out of Memphis, Tennessee, I think mostly a black newspaper, I think. And the guy that interviewed me had no idea about anything. He just, you know, saw the Kyrie thing. Hey, I'll look up Flat Earth, and found my phone number and called me, and I answered. And we did the interview, and it happened to be my 100th interview. So fantastic. Really loved that. Then First Take, that doesn't surprise me. That was one of my favorite shows with Stephen A. Smith and Skip Bayless. But Skip Bayless is now doing his own thing. So Stephen A. Smith and I forgot the name of the other guy, they immediately, you know, were just trying to shut this whole thing down because it can't be real. And then finally, even just today, I did another one from one of the bigger internet shows called 120 Sports. And that's run by different sports things, but it's pretty big. They absolutely went after Kyrie because, and even the NBA, the commissioner of the NBA was asked about it during All-Star Weekend, and he was doing damage control. It took him a while to kind of figure this out, but if you see any video on YouTube or any video that says, oh, no, Kyrie's backtracking, you could it's a safe bet that those stories are coming out of people that have a vested interest in the NBA, because the NBA does not want to be caught giving people credit where it's like saying, well, the NBA is just full of uneducated people. They don't want to do that. You know, the NBA's got people that believe in flat earth. It's like, screw the NBA. I'm going to watch football or hockey. They don't want that. So they've got, you know, it's still about the money. They're going to try to do some damage control if they can. And anyway, that was today. And there's going to be more shows tomorrow. What I thought was interesting, and again, we still haven't gotten to the emails yet, and I will, I promise. But it's such a big thing. This guy, Kyrie Irving, and granted, I haven't followed basketball in a little while. I was more of a Jordan guy and back when the first Dream Team, all those guys. But he did more in that 15 minutes on that podcast than 6 months of everybody in the Flat Earth community combined. There's people talking about it now that never, ever would have brought this up because they have to. It's too interesting not to talk about it. And Peanut Gallery says Larry Bird was the man. I don't know. I mean, he was okay. But all the other guys, I mean, look at the personalities Bird was around. Yeah, Bird in a different era, I think, would have been phenomenal. But look, you got Isaiah Thompson and Magic Johnson and Michael Jordan and David Robinson and Patrick Ewing. And it just goes on and on and on. Anyway, where was I? So that was today. And so what's going to happen tomorrow? There's going to be more shows. I will say this again, before we get to the emails. Here's the interesting part, is that I still think a lot of this is being structured because there's an absence of television shows that aren't talking about this, namely the major networks, ABC, especially in the United States, ABC, NBC, CBS, Fox, CNN, all those guys. None of them are running video stories. Now, of course, they absolutely have to run it on the internet. But remember, television is still the lowest common denominator, and there's a lot of people that do not believe anything unless they see it on television. So until Anderson Cooper comes out, if Anderson Cooper comes out and does something on this, then, hey, wonderful. But you know what? I'm going to make a prediction. And that is, if you want to see the next stage in this, let's see if, because this is still one of those lowest common denominator things, let's see if Saturday Night Live does a skit on it, because they got plenty. This happened on a Saturday, so they didn't have time to work it into the last one, but they've got a full week to do it on. And writers, are you kidding? What else? They've run so many Trump skits. This is too easy. In fact, it wouldn't surprise me if they tied a Trump skit into a Flat Earth skit. you know, that Kyrie and Trump were in the same sort of skit. You know, not the real guys, of course, but that's, if I had to make a prediction, that's what it would be. That's my small prediction for the week, is that because if that happens, then that's kind of the bridge between sports news and mainstream news, because lots of mainstream news people like picking up stuff, especially going against Trump. So watch, let's see what that happens there. Anyway, sorry for the people that are trying to call in right now. You cannot. In fact, let me make sure that we are thinking about rebooting. Still haven't heard anything from the studio yet. Studio, if you are listening, would love you to reboot the server just so I can take callers. But in the meantime, I will do emails. In fact, we've only got 6 or 7 minutes to the first break. I know I've been kind of rambling, but I've been rambling a lot. I've made a whole bunch of videos. I've been in total overdrive mode. So let's get to some emails. And what is the first one we are going to read? In fact, let's do, the first one's going to be from Akil Will. And I'm kind of going in reverse order. Normally I go chronologically, but he wanted me to mention this. He goes, great interview with, that's why, because he said something nice. Great interview with the Daily Helmsman. I don't know about other emails, but if you read this on air, cool. Shout out to Bro Sanchez. Awesome. And oh, if you do read the one titled Kyrie Hate to Be the Party Pooper, it would mean a lot. I haven't gotten an email called Kyrie Hate to Be the Party Pooper. All right, brah, later, Akil Will. So thank you, Akil. I know it wasn't a great first email, but I had to do something. So let's go to the second one. Second one's called Mars Question. Howdy, Mark. Always enjoy your interviews, videos, etc. Been addicted to Flat Earth for over a year now. And before I get to the point of this note, I just want to say, no, I already read this thing. This was one of the last ones I read before we... No, Peanut Gallery says bra or bro. He spelled it B-R-U-H, and I don't usually know. I don't know. I'm so white. I don't know what that means. Is it a white thing? B-R-U-H, bruh? I don't know. I don't. I have like zero street cred at all. I'm sorry to say. I am one of the dorkiest white guys you'd ever want to meet in your life. Sorry, 334. Cannot pick up your call right now. I'm going to have to wait till the end of the first break at least, because we're rebooting the phone stuff. And I don't know if I read this one. This one's from Ben. Ben goes, hey, I watched your video about hiding God around a year ago, was instantly hooked on Flat Earth. Took me 6 months of listening before I was confident enough to bring this new revelation to the attention of others. So far, I've converted about 20 or so people from the globe lie. Now, I can't do or watch anything without the Flat Earth coming into my mind from movies and photos and everything in between. So my question is there anything you're not really sure on? You're so confident in the things about Flat Earth that you say, I've always wanted to know if there's anything Flat Earth that you're unsure about. No, I'm not. I'm pretty sure about just about anything at the everything at the moment. I mean, I've answered just about every question I can. I can't. I mean, if something comes down the road where I have to change my posture a little bit, I don't mind. I've said this several times, starting from the beginning, which is I'm not going to lose any sleep if the world isn't exactly how I portray it, because the whole Flat Earth movement is sort of in the same boat, which is we all agree on certain things, one of which is that it's not even close to being a globe, and there's a really, really big secret being hidden from us. Let's see here. What other emails do we got? This one's called Spinning Globe. Hey, Mark, some great slow motion video of a foam ball with water not sticking to it. If you haven't already, thought it might be great footage to include in your videos to disprove gravity doesn't keep water glued to the earth that spins over 1,000 miles an hour. Clint. Yeah, I don't mind those videos, but there's a reason why I haven't included those. And that is because they're, get to remember, it takes 24, if you believe in mainstream science, it takes 24 hours for the earth to spin one rotation. That's a long, long time. And I grant it's 1,000 miles an hour. But more interesting to me would be the question to science, which we still can't get an answer on, and that is, how does gravity overcome centrifugal force? Meaning, if the equator is spinning faster than the upper and lower sections of a sphere, then how is the water completely uniform on it? I don't care if it's spinning off or not. Why is there not this big bulge, sort of like a Saturn's rings, but with water? I'm not saying it's be flying off the planet. But why isn't it bunched up at the center? Why is there any water at all at the North Pole and the South Pole? I don't think that's even remotely possible. This one's from Kathy Dunson, and she's talking about something that we don't want to read because I don't want to get into the politics. I don't mind, by the way, if you send me letters on Donald Trump. I don't. But I've never voted, so it doesn't really have any. And we got 2 minutes to the break. I know, peanut gallery, I'm watching. I don't mind, but I'm not. Politics for me, once I got into flat earth, politics kind of went out the window. Meaning flat earth is so much bigger than not only all politics, but all other conspiracies. So I didn't really care whether Trump won or Clinton won. Either way, they were both puppets in the same system, both bought and paid for. But that's a whole other rant for another time. Can we do one more before the break? Yeah, we can. This one from Veronica. Just watch your video. It makes so much sense. It explains global warming. And another question I had about why the atmosphere is cold if the sun is hot. So thankful for opening my eyes, Veronica. You're very welcome, Veronica. This one's from, do we still have time? Do we have time? No, we do not have time for this one. This one's too long, unfortunately. So when we come back from the break, I'm going to try to see if we can get the studio to reboot before the break. But if we do, the phone number to call in is 720-897-6111. That phone number again is 720-897-6111. You can also email me questions at msargent23@comcast.net. And don't forget about the conference, which is, I know you guys are tired of hearing. No, do not call in yet. Oh, my Lord. The break hasn't even happened. I'm not keeping you over the break yet because I haven't rebooted the server. Anyway, stay tuned.
Truth Frequency Radio.
No hate, no hype, no fear. Real people, real radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. Part 2 of 4. It is Tuesday night, and as you know, basketball's on everybody's mind. So if it's the first time ever listening to the show, or if you haven't been following Flat Earth for a while, just go into any search engine, type in Flat Earth, and watch the news just fly by. It's pretty amazing. Cannot take phone calls at the moment. We are still waiting to get the phone system rebooted. So in the meantime, I'm going to read my nearly endless supply of emails, which is good because if I read emails tonight, that doesn't mean it means I don't have to do an email show maybe tomorrow or Thursday. This one's from Daniel. He just wanted to make sure that I saw the really cool YouTube video called 7.5 or 7-5 mile flat earth laser test on a frozen lake. Very, very interesting video. I highly recommend it. I think it's been reproduced a few times. Where it was interesting to me that the guy that made it was not really a flat earther. He was a metal guy, a mechanic, who specialized in doing instructional videos on how to change parts out on different mechanical vehicles. And he was special. He had some lasers rolling around and snowmobiles and a frozen lake. And so he did a 7.5 mile test over this frozen lake, which severely reduces a lot of the atmospheric things, issues that debunkers will try to point out when we do stuff over water, because you get these kind of the weird wavy effect from line of sight issues and atmospheric lensing or atmospheric looming and all this other stuff. But across a frozen lake, there's almost no, it's great conditions if you can find a good frozen lake to do it on and have some lasers and a snowmobile. And it's a great test. So if you haven't checked it out already, please do. This one's called YouTube videos. Hello, sir. I have been up for 2 days getting my mind blown at your research. Is there a time we could talk? I have several questions. So grateful I stumbled across your truths. Doug Brady. I get this type of email, and the reason why I read this, because it seems pretty generic, and that is I get that type of email all the time. No offense to anyone who wants to talk, but that's how they all start out with it. It's like, mind blown. I have several questions. I know you have more than several questions. You're going to be up for a lot longer than 2 days. So for anyone that's very new to this and friends of yours, realize that you should let them just go through as many videos and absorb as much material as they can before they ask the questions. Because again, like anybody, it's kind of like when I'm doing the interviews. Anyone that's listened to any of my interviews so far, you hear the same stuff over and over. Because the interviewer doesn't know anything, so I hear the same stuff, and I get grief every once in a while. It's like, why, your interviews all sound the same. It's going, well, yeah, it's because it's the same pattern of questions that I get from these people. I rarely do I send them questions. Now, every once in a while, someone will say, can you send me some talking points? Because I really haven't brushed up on your videos. Like, okay, fine. Here's some talking points. But that's, I think, 3 or 4 out of 100 that I had to send talking points. The rest of them, it follows a natural pattern, a natural progression of questions. And so it's not that I mind answering it's not that I mind the people say, oh, yeah, I want to talk about questions. But really, you have to go through a lot of the journey you have to take by yourself for quite a bit of it. So this next one is from who? It's called Flat Earth. It's from MB. Mark, I watched your video today. I'm going to say much of it didn't make sense to me. But in all honesty, I still don't have a valid point in your theory. Can you help me in getting a full understanding? Your theory seems a bit full of crap. Sorry. It's not really a troll, which is why I read it. I mean, people, I rarely get anything with profanity anyway. But in his case, he's just starting down the road. It's going to take him a while. This one's called Great Show Tonight, excited for Flat Earth Conference 17. Mark just wanted to write and say that I am super stoked about the conference in North Carolina. Already got a ticket and a hotel, probably snag airline tickets a little ways down the road. Anyways, I'm sure it will come up quick, and I'm looking forward to meeting everyone in November. I have to say, I've come to the conclusion that most, if not all, of the Flat Earthers that I've met have ended up being the most honest and trustworthy people I know. And that's just a great feeling. Have a great night. Joseph from Iowa, and he's the one with the It's Flat license plate. P.S. thought this video was pretty cool. Just a compilation high altitude balloon video with a nice trippy cool audio track. And, uses Crazy from Seal. Think of Anger, Mutiny, and featuring Seal Crazy Vocal. I did not click on that one yet, but I will. And also, anyone that is thinking about getting a license plate, I do a license plate. If you want to know if your license plate has been already chosen, everything's automated anyway, so you can just go on the internet and find out if the license plate's chosen. But most states, including the Canadian provinces, offer either 6 or 7 or 8 letters, depending on how many people are in your region. So sometimes it'll be only 6, like in, I think, Idaho, maybe 7 for bigger population. Then New York and California, they both have the chance to get 8. And so we've gotten a ton of great plates so far. I think we've gotten half the country so far. But in fact, proportionally, even more Canadian provinces than anything else. 530, do not call in. Can't take phone calls right now because we're still waiting for the server to be rebooted. But thank you for thinking about me right now. I'd love to take phone calls, but I can't. I'd love to talk about the basketball thing. I can't. So hopefully the studio will pick up eventually. We'll find out. Moving on. This one's called They're Hiding Our Creator by Deborah in Brooklyn. Dear Mark, I saw your document on the flat earth and do agree with your findings. As a child, hearing that we are spinning on a ball called Earth has troubled me until now. I used to put many things on something round and they always flew off, even with glue, string, or tape. When I really saw the crap for what it was watching water fly through an extractor and the clothes flew to its sides. Thanks much for the insight of me knowing that someone else saw the wrongness and told about it. Also, in dealing with the firmament, I find it great to think that we can find the end of the rainbow. We just need to go to the frozen edges of Antarctica. Smiley face. The rainbow covenant of promise are seen as an arc, a perfect sign, don't you think, of the dome we are covered with that the authorities are hiding. Love you, Mark. Sincerely yours, Deborah Harris, Brooklyn, New York. Thank you very much, Deborah. And the rainbow is really interesting because not only is it shaped like a dome when you're looking from the ground, but when you go above it, it is a circular dome. It looks like an actual physical, you see the three dimensions of it. You know, it looks like you're looking on down on top of a rainbow sports stadium. It's really, really cool. If you guys haven't seen that yet, look up helicopter rainbow stuff. People with helicopters or planes that fly over the top of rainbows. It's really, really cool. The stuff that's out there. Some great video. In fact, I think I included one of those videos in one of my background things that I've done. This one's called Caprica and VR. Mark, do you ever watch Caprica? I find the popularity of VR headsets disturbingly consistent with the show. Rob, staying ahead of the curve. And yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. And you want to go down the show that I think deals with technology that's so close to ours and how it can be abused and twisted into something perhaps sinister, check out the series Black Mirror, I believe. It's kind of like what Twilight, I think I mentioned it last episode, which was, it's like Twilight Zone taken to the nth degree. Twilight Zone taken to a level that we have not seen before. And it's really creepy. But when you're watching, you can totally relate to almost all of it. But the part where it's just set slightly in the future, maybe just a few years in the future, you never question it. You're saying, oh yeah, absolutely, it could be done. By the way, I don't think I mentioned this at the beginning of the show, but someone emailed me, and maybe I'll get to that email, maybe I won't, that NDT, otherwise known as the world's most popular astrophysicist, is on Joe Rogan's show tonight. So if somebody wants, I don't think that's an accident, or it's a weird coincidence if that's the case. Maybe Joe Rogan dragged him on because Joe Rogan's a sports guy, and he would have definitely seen all the madness that happened this weekend. So bringing in NDT, and then talking to him about it, slipping that in, I know that NDT would have been called at some point. Because when Sports Illustrated wanted to talk to somebody about the Earth, I think they would have tried to call NDT first, and they ended up calling Bill Nye. So, yeah, I'd love to get the audio clip for that, or maybe they got a video clip, but it probably won't be posted until tonight or tomorrow. But if I'm not mistaken, he's on Joe's show tonight. So anyone wants to dig that up, please do, and let me know where it is in the clip, and I'll turn it into a video. And I'm curious to see if he's going to go down the same road as, you know, just comment and try to lump BOB into this. Because remember, NDT went on Comedy Central and dropped the mic on rapper BOB, partially because the rapper used a full 60 seconds of NDT's audio. And Peanut Gallery says, more celebrities come out. Your hero, Joe Rogan. Is that the one? The Joe Rogan? There's the YouTube from the beginning. Oh, all right. Well, if that's it, then somebody track down for me where he says it in there. You don't have to do it right now. Let's see. What else? Let's do this one. Does the moon cause frost? This one's from Dan. Hi, Mark. Since I was a kid, I always noticed that during winter, the ground only really frosted over during a fairly clear night, free of cloud cover. I live in a part of northern England, which, although environmentally colder than the south, seems to have fewer frosty nights. It's an area known for its rain and cloud cover. Could this reinforce the idea that the moon has freezing properties? I don't recall ever being taught that frosts are more likely on a clear night, but my observations suggest that this is the case. Also, I think the folklore figure of Jack Frost has always been said to have a connection to the moon, though I've not looked into this further. Just a thought, Dan. Very possible. And what he's referring to is an extension of the moonlight test. For those of you who don't know, the moonlight is actually colder than the moon shade. And again, well, this is review for some people, which is if it's, I'll use Fahrenheit because I'm American. If it's 90 degrees in the sunlight, then it's 80 degrees in the shade of the sunlight because the object is blocking parts of the sun rays. So you'd expect something similar with the moon, right? So if it's 60 degrees in the, let's say 50 degrees in the moonlight, it should be a little bit colder in the moon shade. Not much because, you know, the moon reflects some of the sun's rays. It's radiation, right? That's what we're told. But it turns out it's the exact opposite. So if it's 50 degrees in the moonlight, it is up to 63 degrees. We've seen up to 13 degree swings in the moon shade. And that is so unbelievably impossible, and science is yet to address that. And I will, again, take credit for the fact that I was on one, because I didn't believe at first when I heard the story. I said, hey, what happens if you take a magnifying glass to moonlight? Does it actually get warmer or is it colder? And it turns out it actually gets colder. You're magnifying cold rays. And we can do this now. We have the technology. We can build cool lasers. So the question is, why is the moon its own independent light source? Well, it's because it's completely independent from the sun. It is a giant nightlight, for lack of a better term. Anyone want to challenge that, check out under my playlist or just go to zeteticism.com or look up moonlight cold test or moonlight test. Jeffrey Grupp does a wonderful thing on zeteticism.com where he shows the moonlight in the shade and a direct moonlight and magnified moonlight. It's all perfectly easy to understand and irrefutable, in my opinion. But do, debunkers, do try to punch holes in it. I dare you. So that was from Dan. Thank you, Dan, for that. And I didn't have the other email queued up, but I will now. This one is called International Postage on a Flat Earth. Hi, Mark. We've been having lots of fun with our shipping parcels. The attached photo, you might get a kick out of it. We sure do. And yeah, what he had done was it was from Australia, and it says flat rate satchel. And you've probably seen this in some of my slideshows. In fact, I use it as one of my thumbnails for Patricia's show on Flat Earth and Other Hot Potatoes, which I think I am doing tomorrow at 3 o'clock. I think, maybe. Is it tomorrow at 3 o'clock? If she doesn't have it scheduled, then no. But usually I do a show with her on Wednesday afternoons at 3 o'clock Pacific. That's 6 o'clock Eastern. Anyway, Australia Post. So he says flat rate satchel, and he crosses out rate with a big black marker and puts earth. And he does that whenever he can. So thank you. That's from GP Gardner out of the Flat Earth, www.flatearth.store. Check that out if you get a chance. Hopefully he'll make it to the conference. I don't know. It's kind of a long way, but we'll see. Peanut Gallery also says, here's the latest stupid quote from NDT. The universe is under no obligation to make sense to you. Oh, God, I hate him. Really? I was thinking about this the other day, and that is all the other people that showed up at the conference, like if BOB showed up, they'd be fine. If Joe Rogan showed up, if Alex Jones showed up, it'd be fine. If NDT actually showed up to the conference, I'd genuinely be concerned for his safety. Because we've kind of cultivated a lot of, I think, animosity isn't even a strong enough word. He's the number one enemy right now. He's the poster boy for all things that are science. And Bill Nye is a distant second. At least NDT, at least he's got a degree in astrophysics. I know it took him a while to get his master's. I think he has master's. He doesn't have his PhD. But if he showed up with that thing, there'd be a lot of people really wound up. We've used him in so many slideshows that I don't think he'd be safe there. I certainly couldn't protect him, nor would I actually want to. Sorry, that's not a threat or anything. I'm just calling what I see. This one's called, speaking of, it's called Flat Earth Conference. Good morning, Mark. I live in Panama City, Panama. I started to research the Flat Earth last year, and I believe it. I started an Instagram account to spread out the truth, and it is called La Tierra Es Plana, Flat Earth Latino, and the followers have been increasing. I know YouTube is better for sharing info, but it is more time-consuming for me, but probably will start doing some videos. I just saw your video about the conference, and I am planning to go. I do have mi vida, and my sister lives in North Carolina, so I think it's perfect. Besides that, there will be most of the Flat Earthers together, and I would like to meet them. Take a look to my Instagram page when you get a chance. It basically shows the basics of the Flat Earth for people who don't. Who doesn't speak English. Nice. That's a nice touch. Hope to keep in touch to share info and grow this movement. Blessings. If anyone wants to email this guy, I'm just going to give his email because I don't want to have people write me and say it. His email is flatearthlatino@gmail.com. Flat Earth Latino. So check that out. And he's in Panama City, Panama. May make it to the conference. Hopefully. We'll see. This one is called, what's this one called? This one's called, I can't click on it. Flat Earth, very original. Hey Mark, here's three tests that can be done. A speed of light test could be done in opposing directions to see if we are moving at all or circling the great attractor. If someone could get day-to-day global temperatures and see if the fuller the moon is, the colder it is globally, maybe. I don't know, though, because if the moon is actually traveling around above us, that means some places are going to get colder and some places are going to get warmer, depending on the angle of the moon. You talked to a guy a few days ago who said he knew the moon was solid because he bounced radio waves off of it. If that is true, I don't think I talked to him. You may have sent an email. They should be able to tell the distance to it by the time it takes, the same way a transducer works on a boat to tell depth. You said you were examining Christianity at one point. Here is a good short 12-minute video that explains Christianity very well. Paul Washer, the most terrifying truth in Scripture. Here's the link. Thanks, Caleb. And to answer the second question, because Mythbusters, that was a show they did because they did something kind of anti-conspiracy where people were saying, oh, the Apollo missions didn't happen. And so their solution was, well, we'll do a laser test to the moon and back, and we'll register some sort of photon signal coming back here next to this observatory or wherever it was, and whatever happened, they said, oh yeah, here's the signal. We got it. They gave each other some really awkward high fives, and that was it. And they say, nope. I mean, they were obviously not going to challenge the Apollo program. It's one of those taboos in this country, at least up until recently, that no one's been able to touch. I will quote Joe Rogan and Alex Jones and George Norrie. Interesting, considering all three of them were at heavy conspiracy guys at one point or another, even though Alex Jones is kind of now more focused on the whole Trump thing, and George Norrie's thinking about retiring, and Joe Rogan doesn't believe in conspiracies at all. But all of them agree that the Apollo missions were absolutely 100% true and not indisputable, no matter what. And I think that's just amazing because if you're a conspiracy guy, the Apollo missions, one of like the big American conspiracies, the others being Pearl Harbor, JFK, and of course 9/11. You throw in the Apollo missions, you know, those are the big four right there. And especially with Joe Rogan, as you know, anyone wants to look it up, it's in fact the best video is by Eric Dubay. It's called The Joe Rogan Mystery, where he takes all the radio quotes because Joe Rogan used to be a big conspiracy guy. And then he turned and went against all conspiracies. Now he doesn't even talk about conspiracies. He talks about cage fighting. And anyone that's into conspiracies is obviously crazy, which is, you never see that ever. Once you're a conspiracy guy, you're always a conspiracy guy. But somebody got to him. I don't know, but somebody did. Anyway, so thanks, Caleb, for that. We got a few minutes to break, and we're just going to keep firing through these emails. Lord knows I got a lot of them. This one's from James. Mark, I'd love to get a copy of Dale's physics paper, The Throne of God. I watched the SME interview, and it was fantastic. SME? You mean Strange World? Sorry, 917, can't pick up your call. Still got to wait for the phone to reboot. Anyway, I really enjoyed it. I'm in the aviation field as well, so it was intriguing to hear an ATC perspective. Oh, air traffic controller. On what they see in the nest. Take care and God bless. Yeah, the guy that I interviewed, and that was back, I can't remember exactly what episode it was for. Subject matter expert. You know what? I hate TLAs. You know what a TLA is? It's a three-letter acronym. I don't use them that much. I hate abbreviating things, and acronyms drive me insane. I know, subject matter expert, you can kind of get away with it. It started way back in the day with SCUBA. SCUBA, I totally understand because it's a really long acronym. But other things, especially if they're like one syllables, not to go off on a rant here, the things that drive me nuts about acronyms is if the word is the same, is also a one syllable word. So instead of replacing three one syllable words with three one syllable letters. That part drives me nuts. But I know it's the whole texting thing. I still, to this day, I've never texted in my life. Never send out a text. Now, of course, people have sent me texts, but I don't even have my phone turned on up here in Canada. So most of the time, I don't even get to check texts. You know, one of these days, I'm going to have to open that thing up. Anyway, if anyone wants the copy of The Throne of God, I've got it sitting on my desktop, and I will shoot it to you. It's not very big, and you guys can read it. It is not light reading. It's a physics paper, so don't think that you can have like three or four drinks and sit down and try to crank through this thing. You're not going to be able to do it. I recommend a very sober afternoon under bright sunlight with some music that won't put you to sleep because it's pretty intense stuff. A few minutes to the break. Think we can do it. Is Strange Peanut Gallery on top of it. Strange World episode 43, Air Traffic Controller. Thank you, Peanut Gallery. This one's called Google Flat Earth on Hillside from some use. Oh yeah. That was the other thing. I completely forgot about that. With all the basketball stuff that happened, I completely forgot that the anonymous person, and I would love to talk to whoever it was that did this on a hillside in Los Angeles, more specifically Riverside. A guy dressed up as a construction worker with a orange reflective vest and a hard hat and a shovel and went on a hillside and carved and shoveled out of the grass Google Flat Earth. Not just Flat Earth, Google Flat Earth. Google in small letters above the giant letters. And he stayed around to get caught by it, but I've never found out who it was. And if he took any camera footage while he was doing it, why he did it, but that was done almost within a couple days before the NBA thing that happened. So talk about your great timing. The conference is announced, followed almost immediately by the Google Flat Earth message on the side of the hill in Los Angeles, followed almost right away by the NBA thing, which is still happening as we speak. There's going to be shows that are going to play it this week. Who knows what's going to happen this week? It's just it's a great start of the year, even better than the BOB NDT thing that happened at the beginning of last year. People are new into Flat Earth. Look up the Grammy-nominated rapper B.O.B. who made a song called Flatline, and you can look up, by the way, the hillside thing. It's also on my YouTube channel, but it's called Flat Earth Message, apparently behind Los Angeles CBS. Yeah, CBS, it was on CBS television in Los Angeles. It was great. It's like all this stuff's happening. I'm kind of scrambling to keep up recently. I've had to crank out a whole bunch of videos, but thank you, by the way, for sending that email, Clint, because with all the basketball stuff, I'd forgotten that it even happened. So we're going to go to break. And when we come back, we've got more emails. Don't know if we're going to do any phone calls because we're still waiting for the phone system to rebooted on the studio side. But if we do, the phone number is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. See you guys in a minute.
This is Truth Frequency Radio.
The wicked ones, obviously under heavy Masonic influence.
Welcome back to Strange World, and you know what? Even before we get back to anything, I just took a 917 area code call. Where are you calling from?
Mark, I appreciate you picking up. I'm calling from North Carolina.
Right on.
And yeah, man, and I just wanted to address this Joe Rogan, Neil deGrasse Tyson interview. I was actually listening to it prior to your show, and it ended shortly after. Very interesting. And I want to start off by saying I think we should show Tyson a bit of compassion.
Okay.
Last time Neil deGrasse Tyson was on Rogan was a couple of years ago. He was extremely arrogant, very frustrating to watch. This time around, although he was annoying in what he was saying, he seemed to be a lot more, or should I say, a lot less arrogant. Rogan was as well. And I sensed and this is clearly in response to Kyrie Irving. I mean, without a doubt. They both seem rattled.
They should be rattled.
Yeah, they certainly should be. And I was thinking to myself that he was contradicting himself. And I was actually thinking of people like yourself, you know, making videos, pointing that out. And one of the comments right now, because, you know, it finished a little while ago, so you can go on there and kind of look at the thread.
Yeah.
Very favorable, thumbs up ratio, unfortunately.
Yeah.
One of the comments, let me just cut and paste into a Word doc. It says, can't wait for all the flat earth vids about this to be made from this. He literally debunks himself, laughing my ass off, etc. The earth is flat, blah, blah, blah. And then someone else, this is interesting too. Someone else points out at 134.58, there's a cut. I've been watching Rogan for years.
Yeah.
And I actually like Rogan, although he pisses me off with his ignorance lately. And you pointed out, you know, yeah, a few minutes ago how
I don't think he's ignorant. I think he knows. He's just playing the game. Anyway, go on. You said there's a cut.
Yeah. So at 1 hour, 34 minutes, 58 seconds, someone points this out and it's getting a bunch of thumbs up. There's a cut. There's an edit. And this is supposed to be a live, live podcast. I've never seen that before. And I've seen countless Rogan podcasts, literally hundreds. So I found that to be very interesting.
Wow. You wonder.
You just may want to look into that.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, you wonder if they let something slip that they realize, like, yeah, we can't say this part on air.
I'm thinking. Yeah.
The Kyrie thing should rattle them. In fact, there was a moment where LeBron James, you know, probably the most famous athlete in the world right now, he comes out, you know, he does that press conference when he was actually, you know, not slamming his buddy. You know, he was just like, whatever he thinks, you know, it's fine with me. And it inspired CNN to actually write that article, which I narrated, which said it's okay. It's okay to question things. And this is a far cry. Let's put it this way. It's one thing to go against a Grammy nominated rapper. You know, you can blame the music industry. It's, rappers, they do a lot of drugs and, you know, the who knows what rappers are into. But if you're talking about a professional athlete at the top of his game, championship athlete, trophy in hand, at the All-Star game with the best of the best. And, you know, these guys are making more money and higher social profile than either Rogan or NDT. Yeah, they should be rattled.
Yeah, and LeBron James is perhaps one of the most famous men on the planet. And the way he handled that, I thought was beautiful, because in reading into it, or what I think is you know, myself reading into LeBron's response, was I think LeBron knows himself he's got to be super cautious with this because he is so high profile. And Kyrie,
oh yeah,
is,
yeah, oh yeah,
LeBron is just mega star.
You saw the guy from USA Today News probably when he went after he was on a mission. He went after Kyrie and he was basically saying, "Look, you've got millions of fans, right?" But he didn't want to insult him too bad, kind of like, stop talking about this stuff because you've got an obligation to keep things in the status quo. And I don't know if you saw the videos that I posted over the last 24 hours, but the one that was on the ESPN show called The Jump, where the guy he was talking to, where he was breaking into all sorts of conspiracies. And that was the guy that interviewed him on the plane. And he's totally into conspiracies. And he was bringing up stuff I've never seen. He rattled off in like 20 seconds. He was going, was 9/11 an inside job? Was there a lone gun with JFK? He even brought up the Trump birther thing. And the host, this woman, she's just squirming in her chair. And so is his coach. She was sitting right next to him. They're like going, oh.
I saw that. Saw that. And that also was beautiful. And what was really cool about it was initially the guy seemed like he was trying to bring it up as, well, yeah, there's conspiracy theories and this and that. But then he mentioned the moon landing hoax. And he said that with some certainty, as if he himself knows it's a hoax, which clearly it is.
Of course it is. So, good point. The moon hoax is basically a gateway to the flat Earth. It is once you can get your head around the moon hoax, then you start going, okay, is it possible? And it makes sense. It does. And listening to Kyrie, when I listened to that podcast, I knew the thought, you know, I've talked to so many people now in the last 2 years. I know the thought processes, and he was absolutely in that flatter thought process where he wasn't going into, you know, laser tests and curvature things. But you could tell he was absolutely there. He knew full well.
He sure was. And Alex Jones says that the moon landing, he claims that they had, you know, this whole kind of safety mechanism where they filmed some fake footage just in case the Soviets got there first. That's all complete BS. But for Jones, and I actually, believe it or not, I like Alex Jones. I know a lot of people in the Flat Earth community can't stand him.
Yeah.
I don't think he's 100% sincere. He does deny the Flat Earth. Although there are people on his staff that do not. McAdoo actually part of Flat Earth.
Two things real quick there. One you probably heard me say on several different things, which is one of Alex Jones' producers reached out to me last year, and they wanted to do a show that was tied to Flat Earth, but they couldn't. They would not pull the trigger because they were afraid of the backlash. They were afraid that, look, Alex is out there far enough that if he all of a sudden did a Flat Earth show, that people would descend on him and go, oh, look, he's gone completely off the reservation. But you know, the guy who lucked out, and he wasn't even his doing, was George Norrie. Because when this came out, the whole Kyrie thing, he actually, in his archives, because he did one Flat Earth show with me in 2015.
With you? I heard that was fantastic.
And he referenced it on his last show. Where he's going, well, yeah, and if you guys want to talk about Flat Earth, here, check out this show we did back in 2015. It's like, he honestly thought it was a joke when we did it. He thought his producer was messing with him, and so lucky for George, but unlucky for Alex, unfortunately.
Yeah, but I mean, great point. Alex Jones, he can't, at least not at this point, he can't come out and admit this truth. And he also mentioned that, I think his father was good friends with one of the astronauts, I think Buzz Aldrin.
That's
horrible. So it kind of goes in, but I know.
I'll tell you, this
is a big deal with Kyrie. This is a big deal.
Yeah, this will still give some people an excuse to get into it, though, because now they can at least talk about it, maybe out of the corner of their mouths, but they can talk about it. I mean, I'm watching shows today on ESPN, which I've watched for years, and these guys are actually saying the words. And I've watched Stephen A. Smith.
I know.
Watching him talk, and he's like squirming. I'm going, holy smokes, this is actually happening.
I mean, he's dismissing it, but he's a very intelligent man. And you know, again, he even more so than Alex Jones cannot even touch this. Otherwise, he's done.
Right.
His profession. So yeah, really good stuff. Super exciting. This event coming up in Raleigh, I am very stoked about. I cannot wait.
Me too, man.
I'm only a few hours away. I'll probably drive there.
Right on.
Yeah, so I'm just really excited. But listen, I want to just express my gratitude for all the work that you've done.
It's, oh, thanks.
We are really inspiring stuff. You do some fantastic work, you and David Weiss and Jaronism, and just you guys are so courageous to publicly get out there and do what you're doing.
Well, or we're completely insane. But anyway, thank you very much. And hey, you have a good rest of your night, and I'm going to see how many calls I can pack in now to the last hour.
Great, Mark. Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
All right, see you, man.
Bye-bye.
Bye. All right, phone number to call in, because we got the phones working, is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. Operators are standing by, and by that I mean me, and we've got a 360 area code calling in. You are on live with Strange World right now. Where are you calling from? I'm guessing Washington.
You are guessing correct, Mark. This is your friend Chase and his best friend Dylan from Olympia, Washington.
Hey, man. What's going on? And hang on. 314, you're going to have to wait till this call's over. Oh, boy. And 775. I got to hang up on both these guys. Hang on. All right. Start talking. What?
Man, what a week we've had, Mark. What a week.
You know, I would have been happy with the whole Los Angeles hillside thing, to be honest.
I didn't even know about that, so you said it.
That's just it. I mean, it happened, and I posted a video on it. And it's like, oh, yeah, look at this, some guy. And what killed me was an 845. I know that's New York. Hey, New York, just hang on. I'll definitely try to get you in before the end of the show. The hillside thing was amazing to me because the guy stuck around for it, and we still don't know who he is. You know,
yeah.
And police were thinking about prosecuting him, or of course, who knows? You know, maybe the whole thing was scripted and it was done, you know, it was like the announcement before, you know, because some people are already saying that Kyrie's a plant. It's like, I don't know. He seems like a believer to me.
Yeah, I think he's like legit because like the way he would say it, like a flat earther would say it, he was saying like, he's not really like trying to convince people, because when you start trying to convince people, then you start sounding really crazy.
Oh, yeah.
If you just say like, hey, like do your own research, like be open minded and question everything, and then you know, he sounds like one of us, you know, he doesn't sound like.
Oh no, yeah, he's using the lines. In fact, he and I can't remember his friend's name who was on the jump. They were both saying the lines like, do your own research. I'm going, yep, I know that line very, very well. So
exactly.
It was fantastic to hear him do it. And I know, you know, when the scientist or when the USA Today was got him to say that, yeah, science shows us that the Earth, you know, is a sphere. But, and people are going, well, he just said it, that science is proven. It's like, no, he didn't say proven. He said shows. And so that's why, you know, like even Bill Nye was saying, well, he sort of backtracked. He didn't actually backtrack at all. In fact, I'm hoping that in the follow-ups down the road, because people are going to be asking him about this for a while now. This isn't like B.O.B. where they didn't, you know, B.O.B. didn't even do an interview, you know, afterwards. Even though he went on tour, he didn't do an interview specifically about this, whereas he's still got the back half of the season to go through. And they may go to the finals again. They've already won. What was
it?
So
exactly.
You could not ask. And the LeBron thing just tickled me to death. And his buddy from Golden State was great, and it was just hilarious. The one I didn't post, and I'm not going to, because this shows you how fast it traveled, was when Samuel Jackson, if you didn't already see it, because he's promoting the new King Kong movie, and he didn't know anything about it, and they said, yeah, Kyrie said the Earth's flat, and Samuel just busts up laughing. And he said that whatever, something to the effect of whatever he's smoking, Kyrie's got to get a new drug dealer. it's like, oh man, seriously, I can't use that because he's totally dissonant.
No.
But it was great. And did you see, you probably saw the Sports Nation was my favorite.
I did see that too when
what's his face on the end?
I forgot the guy's name.
Yeah, I forgot his name too. Ex-ball player was.
Yeah, but he's defending Kyrie and
look, when I'm up in an airplane, I see
him.
Flat. It's gonna take a while for the shock wave to be absorbed into the social media scene, because there's gonna be, again, all these people are gonna be looking into flat Earth, and as you know, sometimes it takes days, if not weeks. And I am expecting more articles down the road about this. It's it's just too big.
It's going to be a lot.
It's too big. And what I'm still waiting for mainstream, again, where are the mainstream shows? You know, what Anderson Cooper, I don't expect to be talking about it anytime soon, unless he's like on the lighter side of things. You know, let's talk about that. But yeah, it's huge, monstrous. I didn't sleep much last night or the night before. I was just buzzing.
I believe it. I was with my friends and like they're not on board yet, but I've been working on them and I was freaking out and they're just like, there's no way this is happening right now.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, watching LeBron ask Kyrie on video if the earth is flat, you couldn't put a dollar value on that shot right there.
Oh no.
Because there's kids, you know, there's people that literally worship the ground he walks on. And people are, you imagine all these kids all over the United States going, wait, Earth is flat? You know, they're typing this in. It's incredible. So, yeah.
We need to get Kyrie on the show, Mark. We need to get him with you sitting down so we can figure out, like, what got him started. And
there's feelers being put out to him already, but it's going to be tough right now because he's in the middle, not to spread sports gossip, because I had to look him up. He's in the middle of an agent change, so he's not in good standing with his current agent. Like he's gonna fire him. So tracking him down, I don't know if he's gonna respond directly to tweets. The community's been very supportive of him so far, but he hasn't mentioned anybody by name. Like B.O.B. was not shy about saying that Eric Dubé was his favorite flat earther. I thought that was cool, but Kyrie has not mentioned anybody by name yet. And to be honest, God help the person that he does mention, because he likes gets cornered, you know, by somebody. And it's like, look, you know, like if he said, why don't you just look up Rob Skiba's work right now? That's SKIBA, and then all of a sudden, Rob has to change his phone number because you know, he won't be able to answer
it. Getting blown up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah, whoever gets mentioned, that's gonna be interesting.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I was going to ask you too. Have you listened to B.O.B.'s like latest album? Because it's like it's pretty new at this year, and it's like all about conspiracy theories.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. My favorite, and I don't want to say the name of it because it's profanity, is Effin' Science Bro, which is where he uses the backtrack from "Blinded Me with Science" by Thomas Dolby. It's a very catchy track. And I like his stuff. It's good. I didn't go to his tour when he was here, and I probably should have. And I'm hoping the word gets out to him, because guess where he was born?
Where was he born?
North Carolina.
Oh, perfect. Oh,
yeah, yeah. Went to school there, the whole nine yards. That's his backyard. So boy, that'd be great. Now, of course, it'd have to be a super secret. He'd have to just drop in. It's not like he's going to show up and start, you know, throwing some tracks down or anything, but I can, if he just showed up with this thing, oh, that would be fantastic.
That'd be so cool. Yeah.
I still think if we can make it that far without some weirdness happening between now and then, I think some celebrities will show up this thing just because it wouldn't make them look as ridiculous. Now, Kyrie's opened up the doors. Like, yeah, you want to show up? Show up, buy a t-shirt, get a button, listen to a panel. Fantastic. So anyway, any parting words? Unfortunately, I'm backtracked with phones. Any shout outs?
Well, shout out to Kyrie, obviously.
Obviously.
And I hope the whole flat earth community, like, really, we got to support him and make sure that he doesn't, like, you know, help him stay strong. You know, just tweet at him, say, no matter what anyone says, like, stay true to what you believe. I think that's, like, really, really important.
I agree. I also think it also helps him. Look, he's already won his titles. You know, he's got a trophy, a world title in hand, and he plays with LeBron every day. I don't think he's got a lot to lose, but the same thing, he's already accomplished so much, and he's not even, what, 25?
I think he's 20. Yeah, he's 23.
Is he 23?
He's my age, yeah.
Holy smokes, yeah. The guy is, nothing but good things for him. Look, he played well in the All-Star game. He did the three-point competition, didn't make it, you know, didn't win it. But he's still considered, what, the number one guard in the NBA right now. So, definitely. Hey, more power to him. Yeah, but we, of course, will support him any way we can. And I would love to get him on the show. Anyone wants to shoot things out to Kyrie, I would love to talk to him on this show. And he can talk about whatever he wants. I will not get in his way. So I'll show him nothing but love.
Yep.
All right, man.
Okay. And then shout out to my friend Dylan that's here listening with me. Cool. And oh, yeah. Mark, it's bruh, B-R-U-H. It's bruh, not bro.
Bruh?
Bruh, all right. Yeah.
Again, I do not have a lot of street cred. So, bruh.
It's right. Okay. We're going to help. I'm going to help you out throughout the way.
Right.
With the street talk.
I will do what I can. All right, man. Hey, you have a good night, okay?
And thanks for taking my call. Yes.
Okay.
Too.
Bye. All right, 314. We're stacking and packing them. What's where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Missouri, and my Lord, it's awesome to talk to you, man. So it's just it's an honor.
Oh, I don't know, but is this your first time calling?
First time calling, but I've been listening for a while now. I actually found out about you from Rob Skiva's Nephilim research.
Nice.
And my buddy Rich Morgan, who lives in Missouri with me, and he's gonna laugh hysterically when he hears his name. He told me it was flat, and I was like, okay. I mean, this guy's known me since I was 3 years old, so I mean, what he tells me, I kind of just go with it because it makes sense to me. Because he's a very smart guy, and he would never steer me in the wrong way. And with Skiba being our main guy, we just kind of, you know, the religious aspect of it, it all lines up perfectly. You know, yeah. I was raised by a pastor for 15 years, so just it makes sense. But I'm going to get in, man. I'm getting into the community. I'm going to start making videos. We have the Arch in St. Louis.
Nice.
Portland.
Get some shots there. Yeah.
Well, nobody's brought it up in the community, and it's because we're in Missouri. We're flyover. So, I mean, I don't expect people to really bring us up, but they say you can see 50 miles out from the top of that thing.
Nice.
Well, that would put you in about Lebanon, Illinois. Well, that's where Rich grew up, and that's where, you know, he's got family. So we're basically just going to try and set up a big setup of sorts to try and see exactly how far we can see. And I've been to the top of that thing, but it was when I was in like third grade. It's been a minute. I'm 28 now.
Gotcha.
It's been a few minutes, but yeah, I'm going to try and set some stuff up and try and get that to happen. You know, it shouldn't really be that hard because I have weekends off. So, but you know, I've been listening to you for a while, and I think I listened to the clues maybe 2 or 3 times a month, just because.
Don't do that. Well, hopefully you didn't fall asleep while you were, I was in your ear.
No. I drive for a living, so
okay.
You are. It's really. It's like, all right. I listen to some Nephilim. I listen to this, and then I get you on tonight, and then I get you and Patricia Steer tomorrow. So it's just. It's nice. I got stuff to fill up my whole week. You know how
nice.
It gets a little boring, but
awesome.
I just wanted to call, and I'm gonna make it to the convention or conference, not convention, same thing. But,
oh yeah. Conference convention. Yeah. And Rob and I will both be there. So that'd be awesome.
Yeah. And it's just, I want to do something because it just feels like it feels right.
I know.
It feels right. It just makes sense. I can't stop looking at the sky. I look at Polaris or the North Star or whatever God's window, whatever you want to call it.
Yep.
And I'm just like, why is it not moving? Why does it not move? It drives me
totally
up a wall. that drives me up a wall. And your theory on meteorites, that makes sense for me too. The whole idea of maybe just the idea of shooting something out of a cannon, like that makes a ton of sense to me too. It's just all of it just, it's like dominoes falling.
I know.
One just hits and hits and hits. And I just want to say thank you, man. It's awesome. I love listening to your show. I think it's cool how you have an interaction with the community. You know, a lot of people don't do that. And it's just nice. You know, I'm excited for the conference because I'll be able to shake hands with you and Rob and just, you know, buy you a drink, you know, something like this. Because it's just, I don't know if you can hear the passion in my voice.
I do. I love the enthusiasm, man, and keep it up. And again, it's good. Yeah, the conference is going to be a great time. And I, again, hope you can make it. But we'll talk before. Try, you know, call in again. Not to rush you off. We're going to go to break here in just a minute. But definitely call in. You know, we've got plenty of time before now in the conference. So, you know, try to be a regular caller if you can.
Definitely is going to do my best for that. I got one shout. I know you're
What do you got?
Rich Morgan, you're like a second dad to me, and he does have a business. It's called Saga Toys. It's a toy store, local toy store. You know, it's got every possible toy you can think of in it. I mean, from Transformers, Star Wars, you name it, collectibles. And
nice.
You know what? He deserves a promotion.
All right. All right.
That's the plug.
Cool, man. All right. Well, you have
a good
night, okay?
Have a great night.
All right.
We'll do. Thanks, sir.
Bye-bye. All right, 775 area code. We're going to go to break here in like a minute. Can you stay through the break?
Sure.
Okay. Mute your microphone just because I think we're going to hear road noise.
Okay.
If you can, or just be hang on. Anyway, bear with me for a second. By the way, where are you calling from?
I'm actually in Alabama right now. I'm just a truck driver, just driving through.
All right, on. Hey, 845 area code. I know who you are. You're going to have to wait until after the break after I deal with Alabama. But we're going to go to break here in a minute. The phone number to call in, your last chance to call in, will be next segment. And that is 720-897-6111. That is 720-897-6111. We are talking Flat Earth. Of course. Stay with us. 3 minutes.
No hate, no hype, no fear.
You're listening to Truth Frequency Radio.
We are TFR.
Welcome back, Strange World. And no, I cannot sing that song. And the peanut gallery is going, sing it, sing it. No, I cannot pull off Joe Jackson. He's a very talented singer. And no, I cannot do it. I can do a few other things. Karaoke bar, I might be able to pull a few things off. But yeah, I haven't even been drinking. All right. So that, by the way, that was Joe Jackson stepping out from his album Night and Day. Alabama, are you still on the line with us?
Yeah.
All right. What's on your mind, man?
Hey, Mark. How are you?
I can't complain. Not this week.
All right.
Yeah,
good.
It's surreal this week, so I don't even know where my head is at. But what's going on in your head?
Not a whole lot. I just had to, you know, build up enough nerve to call you. I've been listening to you for a long time.
Oh, this is your first time?
Oh, yeah, first time, but long time listener.
The quintessential long-time listener, first-time caller?
Yeah.
Nice.
Well,
you're doing great.
Go ahead. So anyway, I wanted to make basically an observation. Sure. I listened to some of your past, I guess your interviews, I guess, when you talk about the dome structure.
Yeah.
The firmament.
Yep.
And when you talk about it, you kind of refer to it as like whoever built this place or made this place was intentionally got to hide it. Was that NASA doing that, hiding it?
No. It was already hidden. The only thing that NASA did was keep people away from it. So, in fact, that's the only part of the flat Earth that's really considered the conspiracy, which is up until the 1950s, I don't really think there was much of a conspiracy because they didn't even know for sure that it existed. And then when they found it, they had to, they conspired to keep it hidden, but they weren't the ones that hid it. No. The structure and everything, that's all the creator. Everything about this place is built by a much, much higher technology than we could ever do. All we did was keep our own people away from it with, using the limited technology that we had.
Okay. I just wanted you to, clarify on that. I wasn't sure what your stance was. I got you. But, because, it says right in the Bible, I mean, don't want to get into too much religion, it just talks about what the firmament.
No. I believe in the firmament. I do. It's just that when it comes to, is the firmament that, you've heard me say this before, is the firmament the handprint of God, or is it just one step closer to God? I don't know. Because the argument that I put in at the very beginning when I started this was, did God build it or did God subcontract out the work?
Right.
Because an advanced civilization, look, we build structures now that are mind-boggling to even our own people, hundreds of years ago. I use the quote, and I may use this in a future thing. I don't remember if it was Sitting Bull, could have been Sitting Bull, but one of the big American tribe leaders, when he didn't realize, he didn't concede defeat until they took him to Washington, D.C. to meet with people. And it wasn't meeting the people, it was the structures. When he saw the things that were built, the giant white buildings that were built in D.C., that's when he knew that he was completely outgunned, because he said, anyone that could build this is so far beyond what we can do that we have no chance. And imagine that, but with us now. And that is, we have a hard time even conceiving of building a structure that's even 100 miles wide, let alone 1,000 miles wide. And right. If that could be done, I was like, look, we're doing things now that we couldn't even explain to our great-great-grandparents right now. How do you explain a 747 or a 777 to somebody even 150 years ago? How do you explain that to them? You can't. Or a nuclear-powered submarine, or any of the stuff that we do. Simple things like a microwave oven. Heck, I don't know how a microwave oven works now, other than it rotates molecules. Oh, but
right. Yeah, I guess the technology's just caught up, right?
Yeah, exactly. We're getting so close now. I mean, let's put this. I don't want to beat this in the ground. Unfortunately, I do have to take some other calls. But let me say this, which is, it shouldn't surprise anybody with the amount of, forget about the things we've invented, things we haven't invented but we've thought about, all the amazing science fiction stories that we've come up with over the years. It shouldn't be surprising to anybody that at least a few of them were going to turn out to be true. We just didn't know which ones they were going to be. Forget about the little things like all the stuff we found, that came from Star Trek. We've done episodes in science fiction like what we're talking about now. We have. I mean, The Truman Show was a movie. Dark City was a movie. And so on and so on. Under the Dome is a television series. We already know the concept. So why is it, when you make it that much bigger, why is it that alien to us? Anyway. Any shout-outs you want to do before, unfortunately, I've got to keep rolling with the calls?
Just to all the Flat Earthers, and I just wanted to say, appreciate all your work.
Thank
you're
you.
Very professional at it. So.
Well, I'm trying to set a good example, and so far it's working. I'm still want Kyrie to endorse somebody. I cross my fingers, hope he says my name at least once.
Did you notice that tattoo on Kyrie's arm?
Yeah, I know, but he's not the only one. I mean, there's all the sports have him. Anyway, I gotta run. There's another call coming in, but you have a good night, okay?
All right, thanks. Keep up the good work, Mark. See you. Talk to you later.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, 845, I know you were calling in, and I don't want to miss you before the end of the evening, so call in now if you get a chance. 845, area code. This is your last chance to call in, by the way. It's 7208. There we go. 845. You are on live with Strange World 845 and Imagine. This is New York.
Hey, what's up, Mark? How are you?
Hey, man. What's going on?
Kyrie. Awesome.
I honestly, if you would have given me 10 celebrities to pick that I would have wanted to endorse this thing, I would never in my wildest dreams. People don't understand it. If you're not into sports, how high up he is on the food chain. He's almost like, if you had to equate it to like an entertainer, he's almost like a Katy Perry in some ways. He's not as high as, say, Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift would be kind of like the LeBron right now, or maybe even Lady Gaga, but he's way up there. Way up there.
Absolutely. Millions of fans. Absolutely.
Yeah. In fact, the Peanut Gallery told me he's got over 3 million Twitter followers.
Nice.
3 million.
Nice.
And unfortunately, the Flat Earth community, you know, chiming in and saying good, you know, giving him thumbs up. I don't know what I hate to think what his Twitter feed is like, because I'm sure they're like, dude, are you serious? Dude, are you serious? How many times is he going to get that asked to him? But oh, and by the way, quote that came in from the Peanut Gallery, because he's obviously checking to see if you're on. He says, oh, and I know this quote by heart, this because it's a great line. There are three kinds of lies. There's lies, there's damned lies, and then there are statistics, which was famous by Mark Twain. Now, what he meant, though, was he was talking about, because I don't think that's necessarily true, because I do believe in the numbers. I say the numbers don't lie, in my opinion. But what he's talking about is that statistics can be skewed by people that use them for advantage. You know, the politician argument. That is, well, you know, 49% of the population voted for me. It's like, yeah, but 51 didn't. Yeah, but, you know, they'll only use part of the numbers.
Right.
And it's like, yeah, I get it. And so I throw out, you know, that I try to be funny and I say, well, you know, 4 out of 3 people don't understand fractions.
So. 20% of the time.
20% of the time, yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, I'm just floored. I really think 2017 is positive.
Yeah.
My question today is, age is an issue of mind over matter. If you don't mind it, doesn't matter.
Nice. I think I've seen that on a t-shirt and a bumper sticker.
Yeah, I'm going with it. You know, I'm at Mark, and this year I'm 50, and that's it. I got to open my mouth.
Yeah, I'm getting close, by the way, just so you know.
Yeah, don't worry. I'll still always be older.
Well, you know, I mean, it has its perks, I guess, but at the same time, you know, everyone.
I got RP card, and I'm saving $30 on the room down in North Carolina.
Oh, right. Yeah, people are booking rooms already. I've already booked my room, but I kind of had to because I was going to be speaking, and I didn't want to. I wanted to be in that hotel.
Yeah, I'm booking speaking because I want to stay at that hotel. I'm not driving at all.
Yeah. Oh, Lord, no. No, because I think they're actually doing an open bar for, like, part of the day for some of the people there, and I can't remember what the details are, but, like, it's like an open bar for, like an hour or two window every day.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I know. I was thinking, ooh, that could be why I can't, you know, I'm not going to be doing it if I'm going to do any speaking, but still.
Well,
it's,
you're going to have to stuff short.
Well, you know what I mean. After. I mean, because I'm doing the keynote speech at the luncheon on the first day, and
that's
then,
the first, right?
But I am doing the last event of the conference, which is the awards show with Patricia. So
now, is that to everyone? What is that? That's
what?
Just for the presenter?
What?
The luncheon.
I don't know.
The luncheon.
I don't know if the luncheon is for just presenters or if the VIPs are involved on that. I don't know. You just shoot the conference people an email and ask them what the deal is. There'll be more details as we get there. In fact, I would imagine the lineup is going to, because there's still a few slots. I imagine the lineup may include some more people before it's over.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
That'd be interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, at this point, it's like, I'm thinking, holy smokes, we could hit critical mass before then, the conference. I have no idea what to think after this week right now. I'm still, you know, I just released another video. You probably saw the videos I'm pumping out. I'm scrambling because I don't know. There's so many, every media outlet has covered it on the internet. So I'm just scrambling. I'm only going after videos because there's so many articles. I couldn't even begin to sort through the articles. But I'm trying to release the video today. It was from Sports 120. I would imagine I'm still looking for some other sports shows and any network things. I'd love for to be on The View. But I'm still, you know, I'm gonna bet some real money on the Saturday Night Live thing.
Oh yeah, they're definitely gonna crack.
It's too tempting not to. It's too tempting. If they don't, then I know something's up. But if they do, I know something's up. So either way.
Right.
Because if they don't, it's like, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you not do it? ESPN has now let it happen on 4 different shows. Sports Illustrated is going to run a full-blown article on it. You know, in the magazine, right. I almost guarantee that. Oh, fact. That's a whole other thing. That's a... The newspaper articles, which are going to come out in the next few days, or every sports magazine article that you have, we're going to have to wait for. It's
no, you're right. I like that it asked him about the flat earth, and he said, that's all you got out of that conversation, and then just turned away. I was like, I like this guy.
Yeah.
You know, he's definitely the jock. This guy's got, I mean, and not that any of the other guy, professionals are morons, but this guy's definitely looking at stuff for sure.
Well, here's, you know, I'm so dense sometimes. I completely forgotten that, and you probably heard me say this, which is athletes, especially not the football players, because they only go on, what, 6 road games, 7 road games a year. The basketball and baseball, though, they're on a lot of freaking airplanes. And,
oh, yeah.
And it's their airplanes. And these guys watch a lot of YouTube. They of course, you know, some of these guys are, you know, once you go down the YouTube conspiracy path, that's it, you're down it. And you could tell he knew the score. And when his friend was on the jump show, he was rattling. If you gave him 20-30 minutes, I'm sure he was into all of them, but he knew all the big ones by heart without blinking an eye, and he had conviction in his voice too, and he was very clever about bringing it up. So
yeah definitely. I mean, and I hope they play this right, you know. I mean, I hope he doesn't fall into the, you know, that media blitz of, oh, you're nuts and this and that, and just stands his ground, because he's definitely intelligent. And
oh yeah, yeah. And you saw that, did you see that thing where Bill Nye came out and said it was sad? And it was tragic that someone would still think this.
Bill Nye, the douchebag guy. I'm sorry. He infuriates me every time I see his face and he opens his mouth. Oh.
Yeah. You know what? I mean, let me do a 60-second rant real quick. This is for mainstream media. If anyone in mainstream media is listening to this, you can't keep pushing. I know that Bill Nye looks like a credible nerd that knows everything about everything. But you can't keep bringing him on to different shows all over the place and put him on panels just because he looks like a nerd. He has no master's degrees in anything. He's got a bachelor's in mechanical engineering. And yet he's on the Weather Channel talking about meteorology. He's on different science panels talking about astronomy, astrophysics, geology. He's talking about all this stuff. He knows nothing about anything, and they keep putting him on the air because apparently he's the only scientist that can actually talk on camera, even though he's just an actor pretending to be a scientist. And I know Truth in Advertising, technically his title is the science guy, and he is a science educator. I know that they're very careful about that, but they don't put that as a disclaimer when they're bringing him in. You know, they just say, oh, yeah, it's Bill Nye, science guy. Oh, guys, guy's probably got like 4 master's degrees and 3 PhDs. He's probably writing a PhD right now. It's like, dude, killing me.
Yep, they all assume he knows what he's talking about.
Killing me. Oh, so anyway, yeah, he came out against Kyrie, and of course. And I've got a funny feeling that they got him because I don't think NDT wanted to talk about it. On camera, because then it'd be like, okay, dude, didn't we bring you out on Comedy Central to go against a rapper, and now we got a guy who's actually making more money than you and some of his teammates, so now what you got up your sleeve? So I got to watch.
I mean, you walk into an inner city, I bet you they know Kyrie Irving more than they know NDT.
Damn right they do. Damn right. I mean, Kyrie Irving's got massive street cred, huge street cred.
And Bruh, B-R-U-H, I believe comes from, it's the Hawaiian thing, because they always called you Brudda.
Could be. Again, I am way too, yeah, I would not last very long in the inner city. Seriously, be bad. It'd be bad. It'd be like Bruce Willis holding the sandwich sign in Die Hard 3 bad.
Yes, absolutely.
And I wouldn't even have to hold a sandwich sign. I'd just be walking down the street and people would be like, oh, there's a guy that needs to be taken out of here.
He's too white bread.
I am so unbelievably white and horrible. It's just, I feel bad because I have got no cool. I've got no rhythm. I've got none of that stuff. So anyway, there's a couple more calls I do want to get. I hate to cut you short, man, but as you know, we didn't get calls in the first hour. Any shout outs you want to do? And we'll have plenty, you know, we'll have plenty of time between now and then. Who knows what's going to happen in the next week?
Yeah.
1 week in the world. By the way, did you see that thing that was carved on the hillside in Los Angeles?
No,
hang on. 215, call back in a couple of minutes. I swear I will take you before the end of the evening, okay? You didn't see that thing in the hillside?
Yes, I heard about it. I didn't get to see the picture of it, though.
Oh, you don't have to see the picture. I made a video. It's on my channel.
Oh, okay.
CBS Los Angeles covered it. I mean, the television station covered it. That was the weird part. If you believe in weird coincidences, that CBS runs this story about Google Flat Earth, this big banner carved on a hillside in Los Angeles, even though the guy, whoever did it, is not taking credit for it. And then a few days after that, Kyrie, you know, drops a Flat Earth bombshell on basically the media world. I mean, and talk about your perfect timing. I mean, right before he lands for All-Star Weekend, you know how many press people are at that thing.
On him when he landed. By the time he landed, they were already close.
Yeah, they were ready. They were ready for him. It's freaking real, the amount of media attention he generated that quickly.
Like I said, I think this is the year. I mean, I'm like you said, I believe this is one of the things that can be a positive conspiracy if we do it right.
Yep.
No, I don't think ever, even if it is being used as part of a PSYOP, because I don't think in itself it could be a PSYOP because of what we believe. But
I know.
Who knows? Maybe they are part of it.
I know. The storyline has to move forward, though. And either way, I don't care because, and you've heard me say this, either way, you got to finish out the story. If the heroes walk into a trap, they walk into a trap, but you won't know until you get there. So
right.
We can't dodge this stuff forever, and I can't wait. If this is the beginning of the year, I can't wait to see what happens next. So anyway,
absolutely,
man,
I got a quick quote.
Go.
It's better to keep your mouth closed and let people think you are a fool than to open it and remove all doubt. That's for you debunkers that don't even research and put out videos. I get frustrated because I'm looking to those for answers, you know?
Yep.
Like you, maybe there's a scientist out there who says, hey, dumbass, you forgot to carry the two.
Right.
And I look at these and it's 5 minutes of people calling everybody schmucks and flat earther idiots. And that's it. It's just frustrating.
Yep. I totally
agree. Alrighty. You work and don't worry about street cred. Keep doing it the way you're.
All right. I'll try not to. All right, see you, man.
Have a good one. I'll talk to you next week.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, last chance to call in. I'm looking for, I think it was 215. 215, you, I know, I, hey, there they are. That was fast. Here we go. 215, area code, you are probably the last caller of the evening. Where are you calling from?
Hey, it's Sean from Boston. How you doing, Mark?
Hey, Sean, what's going on, man?
Hey, you know, maybe I tried to be the first caller, but now I'm the last caller this week.
No, I'm sorry. We didn't have the phones turned on.
Hey, you know what? I forgot you were on tonight. I was watching TV with my girlfriend, you know, but I just remembered, you know, I've been listening for the last half hour or whatever. It's been a crazy freaking week, huh? Holy crap.
Yeah, you can say that. I literally just kept making video after video after video, and I have templates built.
I've seen them all.
I could not.
That's beautiful.
One point, I could not get them out fast enough. I'm not even ripping.
Listen to this though. Quote of the week though.
What?
LeBron James. The earth is flat, right, Kyrie? Yeah.
I know.
Are you kidding me?
I know.
LeBron James said. And he said that's, and then after that he goes, that's news. Are you kidding me? That's big right there.
I mean,
and they haven't even painted him as a crazy guy. They're just like, you know, he went to Duke, you know, that's his opinion, blah 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 blah.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And they're just like, it's beautiful. This is what we've been looking for.
I know that
it's kind of weird though that it's February again though. You know, it wasn't B.O.B. February, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, January going into February. Yeah, it was about this time last year.
Yeah, little bit of a stage type of deal there. You know, I have my suspicions.
I know. It's the same.
You know, even if it is though, because like what? The Earth's flat, but here comes aliens. Oh my God! Now New World Order. Blah blah
there
blah.
You,
you know, you never know.
Yeah. Let's put it this way: you could not put it. You've heard me say this. You could not put a dollar amount. I mean, LeBron is the most endorsable athlete there is right now.
Exactly.
And you could not put a dollar amount on him saying.
Well, besides Tom Brady.
Oh yeah, Tom Brady. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not knocking Tom Brady.
Yeah.
I know you guys love.
Yeah, no, not put. I'm just pushing your buttons.
I know. That's all right. I'm Tom. No, Tom
but,
is what he is. But no,
no.
I'm talking.
Yeah,
as
but
far
LeBron,
as...
Jesus, though that name right there. Everybody knows LeBron. For him to even speak the words "flat Earth" is just a miracle right now.
And he wasn't like shaking his head when he was doing it.
No, he's like he. They even quoted him as saying "flat Earth is okay."
Yeah.
That's what they said.
Yeah. Yeah. And granted, now in the context, it's like, well, look, he's your star guard. He gave you a championship. And,
he's clutch.
And it's like, well, what's LeBron going to do?
He called him his little brother.
Yeah. Yeah. Is LeBron going to shoot him down? Hell no, he's not going to shoot him down.
He called him his little brother, basically. He's like, yeah, no, that's his opinion, you know.
Yeah.
And then all these other four other people in this industry coming out saying like, oh, yeah. Yeah, we support his belief. You know, it might be flat. Blah blah blah. All those other things going on.
Yeah.
You know, and then even the interviewer people on the shows, all the basketball shows, saying like, it might be flat. Who knows? Who's to say it's not? I mean, he went to blah 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 blah. You know, all this.
Absolutely.
You know, and then there's those obvious like, oh yeah, he's a troll. He's a troll. Blah blah blah.
Yeah. Yeah,
that obvious. But you know what? Freaking, I grew up in Worcester, Massachusetts, and the DJ people now they're doing the first time ever, all the people in the community of like, you know, cause I've known people, they've just made fun of and trolled and trolled and trolled and trolled for the last year. And now there's a flat earth event going on at my local favorite bar.
Nice.
I don't even know if it's a troll event or not. They're
dude, we got, we just, you know, we got 30 seconds till we're off air. So make it quick.
I convinced some new people with the fact that how can we can see Venus at night? There's a big, simple fact. I wanted to bring that up.
Nice.
You know, how can we can see Venus at night if, you know, it's a smaller orbit than, you know, if we're facing away from the sun? You know, that convinced two different people this week after they heard about the, you know, Kyrie Irving thing.
Yep.
So, yeah, that's that. And I'm glad I got to get my call in. And thanks for keep putting those out.
All right, man. Hey, you have a good one.
All right, you too.
All right.
Bye.
See you again. Hey, guys. Bye. See you. Same flat time, same flat channel. Hey, who knows what new celebrity is going to come out this week? Stay tuned.
What is this? Is that a model of the flat geocentric earth?
I had to make a new one. What are you doing?
Oh,